I do want to talk to you about why I'm running. And I'm just going to give you one example tonight. I actually could talk to you all night about why I'm running. And a lot of it has to do with my family. I am a truly middle-class girl. I grew up as a child of a plumber. I have parents who are 76 years old. Medicare and Social Security matter to them. I have a brother who's an iron worker. A good wage and jobs matter to him. I have an 18-year-old nephew that when the House Republicans and Vicky Hartzler vote against Pell Grants, it matters to whether he can get to college. Those are just a few of the reasons why to run for Congress this year. But I want to give you a really more specific reason tonight that is really important to me, and I'm sorry the Attorney General isn't here because I was going to talk about him for just a moment, because one of the things that truly mattered in 2010 was that he did a study on domestic violence in the state of Missouri. And it was a really good study, and it mattered. And we're going to talk about tonight domestic violence. In the prosecutor's office, we make decisions because we have to decide what is right, what is good, what is just. When we have new assistant prosecutors come into the prosecutor's office, we don't talk about statistics and counting convictions. We talk about seeking justice. On this case today, did you do the right thing? When you went home, did you feel good about what you did? That's what the prosecutor's office is about. And I think that making those hard decisions, using good judgment, is about going to Congress. And so I do want to talk about domestic violence in particular. I have made it a priority in my office, and I was really honored to get the 2010 Missouri Attorney General's Award for domestic violence prevention. It was really important to me, and I'm really proud of that honor. I was a member of the Hope Haven Board, and in fact, the Hope Haven Board has a domestic violence coalition that still meets once a month with my office. We were able to bring SANE nurses into Cass County, to the Cass County Hospital through Coversa, something that had not happened before. Women who were sexually assaulted had to go all the way down to Kansas City in order to see a SANE nurse. To have domestic violence as an awareness in a county, in every county in Missouri, is important, and the Attorney General did a really good job following through with that study in 2010. Domestic violence is real. It exists in our communities. I want to give you a quick example. In 2009, you had a young woman who for several days was held hostage by her boyfriend. He injected her with meth. He beat her with his fist. He beat her so badly with his fist that when he put his cigarette out on her cheek, she said she didn't really remember feeling it. He beat her with a green metal baseball bat on her legs and her arms and her body. And she was so brutally beat that her family didn't recognize her when she finally got to the hospital. After he beat her for several days, it occurred to him she might not make it. He might need to get her some care. And so he wrapped her in a rug, and he put her in the back of her car and drove her to the hospital. Only he went past the first hospital, which was about 5 minutes from his house. And he drove on up the highway past the Belton Research Hospital, which is about another 20 minutes. And she's in the back of this car the whole time, brutally beat, wrapped in a rug, believing that he's actually going to drop her somewhere. He's going to leave her to die in a ditch. He's not taking her to the hospital. It's just been too long in the car. He finally gets to the research hospital downtown, and he leaves her there, takes her car and drives back home, hoping nobody recognized him. She was, in that time, fearful that she was going to die, brutally beat, and in my office, a young woman named Monica Penrose tried that case in front of a jury because she's dedicated and hardworking and believes in taking care of the victims who come to the Cass County Prosecutor's Office. And I thank you, Monica, for that. You did a great job. Judge Cook actually sentenced this man to 20 years in the Department of Corrections. And it was a case that really touched everybody in my office. Now, having said that domestic violence is real, we have a new case in our office every week. Last week, the House Republicans and Vicky Hartzler voted to not renew the 1994 Violence Against Women Act. It's unconscionable. Now, keep in mind, in 1994, The Violence Against Women Act actually was bipartisan. Over 40-some Republicans voted for that in 1994. And in fact, when it needed to be renewed, George W. Bush signed it back into law in 2000 and 2005. And yet, this group, this House Republicans, this Vicki Hartzell, played a political game. In the prosecutor's office, we understand that it's not about making decisions whether you're a Republican or a Democrat, or who you are. It's about making decisions based on good judgment and making decisions based on real people and what's really important and solving problems. These Republicans continue to play games. That's why I'm running for Congress. Now, we all are here tonight. You could have been many places, and you chose to be here tonight. You chose to be here tonight because you understand that each one of us believes we can make a difference, and we can. You know, when we look as Democrats at what's important, we're looking at American values. We believe in American values over billionaires. And we believe in American values, and we believe in seniors and Medicare and Social Security over billionaires. And we believe in creating jobs for middle-class families with good wages over giving benefits to billionaires who take those jobs offshore. And so for me, the focus is about real people. It's about my family. I can't be happy if my family's not happy. And that requires protecting Medicare and Social Security and making sure that all of our folks that are important to us are protected. And so as we go on through the evening, what I realized when I was visiting tonight was that I couldn't just tell you why I'm running. I realized talking to many of you, I need to tell you why I thought I could win. I had many of you ask me that question, in fact. And so I'm going to talk about that for just a minute, and then I'm going to finish because we have someone really important to honor tonight. This is a different district than 2010. In the redistricting, they took out Ray Lafayette, Saline County, and they put in Boone County, Columbia, Missouri. I've been to Columbia 7 times since February 1st. We met yesterday at 2 o'clock with MU students. I'm very excited about having Boone County. They make up 24% of this district. Cass County makes up 16% of this district. I've been on the ballot in Cass County for the last 10 years. But what's good about that is, let's remember, Boone County wasn't in there. Vicki Hartzell's name has never been on that ballot. And even more so, Belton and Raymore were in Congressman Cleaver's district, a place I've been on the ballot for the last 10 years. There's almost 30% of this district that Vicki Hartzell's name has never been on the ballot. I've been running in Cass County, and I've been running there strong. I think the people of Cass County know how important they are to me and how important the Cass County Prosecutor's Office is to me. This is a race that we can win. We intend to continue to work hard. We continue to get out. But of course, we all know it's about raising money. I didn't start until about January 23rd raising money. But I want you to know, as Democrats, for the first quarter, I raised over $250,000 in 2 months. Statewide candidates have gotten a lot of the money, and so people are being hit hard. Democrats are going to be asked really this year to get to the bottom of their pocketbooks and the bottom of their pockets, because it's going to take a lot of money to win all of these races. But I really would ask that you join me on HensleyForCongress.com. Please go on, take a look at the website, and take a look at the Facebook, and I hope that you will give me your voice to your neighbors and your friends, give me your vote and give me your support. And I very much believe that I am ready to run for Congress. I am ready to represent you in DC, and I hope you'll give me your support. Thank you very much.